am I in him? This is very important question. Who am I in him? Not who am I in the flesh, but who am I in Christ? Because in the flesh we are weak, in Christ we are strong. It speaks about his exceeding great power. Exceeding great power to us who believe. You see, many times we say, I don't have power, I cannot do it, we are very weak. And the Bible speaks about exceedingly great power of God. Not only power, not only great power, but exceeding great power. This means that it is power above every power. And this power works for the people who believe. So the problem is not with the power. The problem is with the believing. You see? The problem is not with the power. You can put your hand on your stomach, on your belly, and say, there is exceeding great power working in me. But this exceeding great power works through faith. And it says about this power that it is according to the working of his mighty strength. Every time power, might, strength, greatness, exceeding power, it is power that the words cannot describe. The power of God is unlimited. The Spirit of God is unlimited. The power of God is unlimited. The only thing that can limit the power of God is our doubt. Zweifel. The Zweifel, the doubt, is the enemy. Our enemy, an enemy of the power of God. That's why we need the Word of God to get faith, that the power of God may work strongly in us and through us. And now if we ask what kind of power is this and go to the next verse, we'll see that this power that works mightily in us is the power that raised Jesus Christ from the dead. This same power, this same dynamis power, dynamite power, works in us. And this same power that raised Jesus Christ from the dead works in us. It is not weaker power, but it is the same power, 100%. Then this means that this power is a power of life and power of resurrection works in us. So if you start to think upon it, you will see that it is not by might and power, but by the Holy Spirit, everything will become possible in our lives. Only we have to trust him and trust his power. And his power raised Jesus Christ from the dead. And his power made him sit on the right hand of God in heavenly places. And this power gave Jesus Christ authority over all powers. great power. Verse 21 says, far above all rule, authority, rule, authority, power, dominion, and every name or every title that can be given, not only in the present age, but also in the one to come. All the powers that exist in heaven and on earth are under his authority, because he was elevated, he was put to sit in the third heaven on the throne, on the right hand of the Father, having name that is above every other name and authority that is above every other authority. And when we think about him having this great authority, we can say, yes, but this is Jesus having this authority, but what can we do now? But we have to understand that Jesus Christ is the head and we, the church, are the body. So if he is seated on the throne, he is seated with the whole body on the throne. And we are also there. Every born-again believer, wiedergeboren, is seated in heavenly places. Physically, you are in Innsbruck. Spiritually, you are in heaven. That's why when you speak to the devil, to demons, the demons tremble in the name of Jesus. Because they see your spirit in authority. And they see the power of the Holy Spirit inside you. You remember Jesus Christ when he sent his disciples in Matthew chapter 10. The first thing he gave them was authority. Chapter 10, verse 1, Jesus called his disciples, gave them authority and sent them. And he gave them authority over two things. Number one, over spirits. He gave them authority over spirits, evil spirits, all evil spirits. And then he gave them authority over sickness. It looks like sickness is a person. He gave them authority over all sickness to heal all kinds of sickness and disease. So he gave them authority over spirits and over sicknesses and sent them. But the Bible doesn't say he gave them power, because the power they received in Acts chapter 1 verse 8, I mean in Acts chapter 2, you shall receive power after that the Holy Spirit comes upon you. So the power comes with the Holy Spirit, the authority comes with the name of Jesus. And the authority comes with the new birth. The moment you are born again, you are son of God. And as a son of God, you have authority. You have heavenly passport. You become son of the king. And you have heavenly protection. You have heavenly immune system against the powers of darkness. And Jesus said in Luke chapter 10 verse 19, I give you power, I give you authority to trample upon serpents and scorpions, and power over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. So Jesus said that with this authority, nothing can hurt us. So the authority comes when we are born again. We are seated with Jesus Christ in heavenly places. In Jesus Christ. In a place of authority. And when I go back here to Ephesians chapter 1, verse 21, he was far above all rule and authority. Far above all. And verse 22, God placed all things under his feet and appointed him to be head over everything for the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills everything in every way. So everything is under the authority of Jesus. And then in chapter 2, verse 6, the Bible says, God raised us up with Christ and seated us with him in the heavenly realms in Jesus Christ. You see, we were raised from the dead together with Jesus Christ, and we were seated on the throne together with Jesus Christ. So, together with him, we have the authority because of him and in him. And verse 7 says, in order that in the coming ages he might show the riches of his grace. So in order in our time, the Lord to be able to show his great mercy, his great grace, his great power, he has seated us in heavenly places to enable us, to give us authority to do his works. Everything is possible for him who believes. We are talking about this in order to walk in more authority and more power. And you remember in John chapter 14, John chapter 14, Jesus said, verse 12, John 14:12. I tell you the truth, if you have faith in me, the works that I do, you will do also. And whatsoever we ask in his name, we'll receive. In the name of Jesus, we can receive whatever we ask. Then we understand that using the name of Jesus by faith, understanding the authority we have, we can move the mountains. Amen.